let's put our hands together, brothers and sisters, as we celebrate the life of our father, husband, friend, uncle, Brother John Thomas Brown. He lived to be 94 years old. That is a blessing to be celebrated. Let us adhere to the program that has already been printed. At this time, we will have a selection by the Friendship Baptist Church Choir, followed by prayer by Reverend Alfred Hosley, scriptures by Deacon Ty Moultrie, Deacon Alfonso Edwards, solo, Reverend Jimmy Ewens, reflections, 3 minutes please, Frank Bolden, Calvin Hunter, Honesty Span. One more selection by the choir, followed by the eulogy by yours truly. Finally, acknowledgments by Pope T. Wakefield, Funeral Home, and the recession. Please adhere to the program. Let us welcome the choir.
us, O Lord, and let us look forward to the day when we all can reunite with our loved ones that have gone before us. For they have only paved the way that we too must follow. Have mercy, Lord. Now, Lord, we want to thank you. We want to thank you. will last with us most is the blessing that we were together.
Bolden family. He had many titles: John, Daddy, Uncle John, Brother Brown, and he answered to them all with the same warm, entertaining possibility for engagement. He loved God, his family, and other people. He lived a long life full of rich rewards that flow to those who act justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with God.
Yes.
John was quiet.
Amen.
He was reserved, but he was not shy. And his smile and deep chuckle would light up any room. He did not initiate contact, but when approached, he would talk softly about almost any subject. In the 70 years that I had the privilege of knowing him, I never once remember him raising his voice. He truly loved the Lord, serving faithfully as a member of Friendship for 3/4 of a century.
Yes.
Last year, when I thought I might be too old to continue singing in my choir, my church back home, I thought of Uncle John still singing here in the choir, and I put on my robe and kept on singing. That's how John led, by example. He never told me what to do. He just lived a life filled with gratitude for the blessings he received. He did not seek material things or think that the grass was greener on the other side of the fence. He stayed in his lane. Loved God, worked hard to provide for his family, and enjoyed the simple pleasures like his family, fishing, watching baseball, especially the Atlanta Braves. John and Massimé set the standard for marriages.
Yes.
When we celebrated their 50th wedding anniversary in New Jersey back in 1997, we thought we were really doing something great. Little did we know that that event would be followed by their 60th and 70th anniversary celebrations later on. Their home has always been a haven for the entire family. John is a perfect example of why you should never judge a book by its cover. One would never guess that this slow, soft-spoken person was an outstanding athlete. John Brown was a star basketball player at Madison High School back in the day. He also was a gifted artist and generous with his time and talent. When I was in the first grade over at Mercer Street School, my new Uncle John, who had recently married my aunt Esteban, drew a beautiful picture of an Indian village celebrating Thanksgiving for me to share with my class and my classmates. John also introduced us to our first Christmas tree. This is back on Davis Street when we had no electricity. So he creatively and carefully lighted the tree with candles and brought great joy into our lives. He was a dependable worker who toiled hard for many years in the floral business here in Albany. John respected people. He did not bother others, and he did not allow others to bother him. I could talk for hours about him, but I also know there are others to share their reflections of his life. So let me close with a story that demonstrated the courage he possessed. When I was a little boy, John got into an altercation with a white man on his job. This was back during the time of segregation, and the whole neighborhood was worried that the Klan would come calling. People were up all night anticipating violence. Everybody was advising John to leave and to leave quickly. John refused. He didn't back down. He courageously continued to live his life, and things worked out. I can't tell you how much nerve and faith that took. But I can tell you that placed John very high on my list of heroes. John Thomas Brown was not a loudmouth, in-your-face type person. He was a superhero, a Mica man, who for 94 years loved justice, loved mercy, and walked humbly with his God.
Jolly and judicious. He always knew what to say, but he was not, and he knows when not to say it and when to say it. His obedience is optimism, assured he can be steadfast in his faith, but also if he could have a zest for life. He carried himself with honor and humility. I don't know any other man that displayed a better balance of discernment and logical reasoning. He was also very noble and non-judgmental, everything, all that. Oftentimes putting his family before his own needs, regardless of who and what storms he had walked through before coming. Then I got to see what Thomas and came across a million tongue twisted words that would describe how thoughtful and tolerant he was. So I decided I'd tell you a quick story about him instead. The one time that John Brown popped me on my body. I was maybe somewhere between 5 and 10. And we used to come to Albany every weekend. Our family lived in Atlanta, so I would come home and spend summers with him. And one summer I got on his last nerve. How much stress, I wouldn't move out of his infamous recliner. I'll admit I was being a spoiled brat, and he knew it. He asked me to move, and I did. So he popped me once. It didn't even hurt, but I cried like a big baby. I think my cry was hurt more than anything. But later that day, Grandpa sat me down to explain to me that I wasn't a baby anymore. That day, I learned a lesson. Never underestimate John Brown. More importantly, I learned that my actions impact everyone around me, and I should be thoughtful in everything that I do. I asked myself yesterday, what does it mean to be a Brown? And I don't know if this is the same for everyone, but Brown is a distinguished last name for me. It's the very color of my skin. And that means a lot. To be a Brown means that I'm blessed, but it also might mean that I may end up bald. Like Grandpa was all my life. It means that I am rich and respectful. And no matter how much abundance I have, I should always respect everything on this earth, from the grains of sand to the bottom of the ocean to the stars in the sky. It means that I am open-hearted and original. To me, that means I should open my heart, but still stay true to myself. I still struggle with that in effect. It also means that I should be wise in the will. I should not only be wise in my words, but in my actions. And that also means that it comes to my own well-being. Lastly, I should never lose faith in God or good. To my family, find what Brown means to you and let that carry you during grief. To my old man, I love you, and I know I'll see you again on the other side in 7 years, inshallah, if it is God's will. Ena li'alahi wa ena ilayalehi raja'un. Indeed, we belong to Allah, and indeed, to him we shall return. Thank you.
this dark environment, this rotting, this marriage, to the grandchildren, great-grandchildren, great-great-grandchildren, to all the relatives, friends, and Mrs. Donna McMillan. We want you to know that we are praying for you, and we are grateful for you. To Jean, John Bodine. Dwells in the secret place of the Most High, shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say to the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in Him will I trust. Surely He shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the perilous pestilence. He shall cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you shall take refuge. His truth shall be your shield and buckler. You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor the destruction that lays waste at noonday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come near you. Only with your eyes shall you look and see the reward of the Lord, because you have made the Lord, who is my refuge, even the Most High, your dwelling place. No evil shall befall you, nor shall any plague come near your dwelling. For He shall give His angels charge over you to keep you in all your ways. In their hands they shall bear you up, lest you dash your foot against the stone. You shall tread upon the lion and the cobra, the young lion and the serpent you shall trample upon your foot. Because He has set His love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I will set him high, because he has known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver and honor him. With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. Brothers and sisters, for the time that desires to share together, I'd like to give a few reflections from this thought, living in the shadow of the Almighty. As we celebrate the life of Brother John Brown, we contemplate the myriad of ways the Almighty provides for and protects those who choose His shadow as their place of habitation. I had the honor and privilege of being Brother John Brown's pastor for the past 6 years. At that time, I got to know he and his family. I came to learn that he was an extraordinary gentleman. I enjoyed watching and hearing he and these in the tenor section of the choir. However, my fondest memory is that of watching his relationship with Mother SMA. Their marriage of 74 years is to be celebrated. Let us put our hands together and celebrate. My prayer for the couples and those of you who are looking for marriage today is that God would offer us the same grace afforded to Brother John and Mother Essie to have long, successful marriages. Brother John was a man of patience and virtue and creativity. God blessed him with the gift of vision. He had the ability to see things in his mind and bring them to life. Brother John had a great personality. He was very quiet, but I knew he was very observant, and I often pondered what he was saying to himself while observing others. While there are many accomplishments I could offer regarding this great man, what stands out most for me is his faith. The mark of a great man is not what he receives, but what he gives. Amen. As I built and continue to build relationships with this family, I see and have seen that his greatest accomplishment was giving his children their faith. As I pondered in my heart words appropriate for today, the Holy Spirit kept referring me to his faith, and the faith that he gave his children. You see, the greatest legacy one leaves for his children is not an insurance check or material gifts. The greatest legacy one leaves is his faith. One has to make the choice to give something that lasts beyond the moment and can provide benefits for a lifetime. these words. This is my legacy for my sons, grandsons, and great-grandsons and all. I leave you knowledge to love God and to always put God first, because through him all things are possible. Learn to embrace his love, his word, and understanding. Through him you will have the strength to be strong men with the ability to be caring, humble, and loving. Always try to be the best you can be at whatever you are doing. Take care of your family and those who need you. Never lose faith in God. I love you. Your father, John T. Brown. Yes, brothers and sisters, before I read those words, God revealed through prayer that this four-letter word needed to be the focus of today's eulogy. Faith is a strong belief in God based upon spiritual awareness rather than proof. Things may not always seem well naturally, but through the lens of faith, one can please God and experience his blessings. Because of this faith, Brother John was able to experience the blessings of living under the shadow of the Almighty. This is a legacy that he leaves for his family. From the resounding opening verse in Psalm 91, this passage assures any believing and committed individual of a number of divine promises and protections. God's very presence shall be a refuge and a fortress from the adversities of life. God's faithfulness will shield you from any deadly pestilence. You will not fear the terror of night, nor any assaults during the day. What an amazing promise given the current turbulence of our nation and world. Moreover, underneath the shadow of God's presence, you will watch your enemies fall to the left and the right. Amazing that God will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. Accordingly, you will have unqualified protection in the affairs of life. Because he loves me, says the Lord, I will protect him, for he acknowledges my name. Finally, in agreement with the Psalter, Brother John would encourage us with a recitation of the 16th verse, which says, with long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. Brother John Thomas Brown's life is reflected in Psalm 91. And he now experiences the blessed rest rewarded to those who remain righteous. To his wife, children, and offspring, honor your husband and father by serving his God. Let the fruit of your lips resound with praises to God. Let your hearts be filled with prayer and adoration unto God for his faithfulness. With your father, may we all proclaim, God is great. Yeah. May God's great name be praised throughout all eternity. Yeah. Glorified and celebrated. Lauded and praised. Acclaimed and honored. Yeah. Extolled and exalted ever be the name of the Holy One. Far beyond all song and song. Beyond all hymns of glory which mortals can offer. And let us say, in Jesus' name, yeah. Amen. Amen. For he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Yeah. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. My God, your God, our God, in him will we trust. Surely he shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the perilous pestilence. He shall cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you shall take refuge. His truth shall be your shield and buckler. You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow that flies by day, nor of the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor of the destruction that lays waste at noonday. A thousand may fall at your side and 2,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come near you. Only with your eyes shall you look and see the reward. set him on high because he has known my name. He shall call upon me and I will answer. I will be with John Brown and family in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. Finally, the Lord says, with long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. And the people of the Lord said,
amen.
Jesus.